Welcome, everybody. This is the Bellagio. Here for two nights.
And then the Venetian after. What a beautiful...
This is my favorite hotel. What a beautiful place. Welcome, everybody. This is my Las Vegas vlog. It is Super Bowl Sunday. I am here in Las Vegas, staying at the Bellagio, which is my favorite hotel here. And I'm just gonna show you the two queen bed room. Here's the bathroom with the long walk-in shower, no door. And you got double sink, toilet, nothing back here. Beautiful big screen TV. I want to say it's 65 inch maybe. Two queen beds, wonderful beds. Great, the covers, very comfortable. Stayed here before. And we got a pool view, which is no additional charge. I love this view. See the mountains here and look at the gorgeous pool area. So beautiful. This is room 11005. But yeah, it's gonna be awesome. And what's cool about this trip is I'm staying at the Venetian right after this. So directly compare the two. Right now, my ranking is, this is number one. Wynn is number two, Encore specifically. That's where I stayed last time. Yeah, so I'll get to compare it with the Venetian. But I was saying the rankings, Wynn number two, this number one, Bellagio. Wynn specifically, Encore, the room, the king's room is so beautiful. Number three, I think is gonna be Venetian from when I stayed there a long time ago. We'll double check it this after this. And number four, honestly, Mirage. I love the Mirage. Love the Mirage. So, yeah. Oh, the closet, in case you wanna. Ooh, they do provide the robes. Forgot about that. Nice little closet there. And there you go. So, and it should let you connect your, whatever you need, HDMI video game systems that I usually bring. The Nintendo Switch. Oh yeah. That's how I do Vegas. Yep. So yeah, beautiful. Beautiful room, love the colors and stuff. By the way, the view is really spectacular. I mean, okay, realistically, from where I'm standing, the phone shows it a little farther than it is. This is really how it looks with through your naked eyes, how close the pool area looks. It's so nice, so, so nice. Let me go back here. But yeah, wonderful feeling here. This is the Lux sandwich from Saudel's to go, $14. Comes with cucumber, tomato, onion, capers, cream cheese, Lux. I picked the sesame bagel. That's pretty good, $14 for Vegas Saudel's to go. And you can do room charge online when you order it. Very good. So we're doing our little own food tour. So the Saudel's Lux was the first thing. Here's egg sled, and we told them to put an over medium egg instead of scrambled eggs in their sandwich, the Fairfax with avocado. Look at this. So let me turn on the flash for this. Okay, we are at, what's this place called? China Poblano. This is the cactus by Jose Andres. This is the cactus taco. And this one is the bean one. Very interested to see. I never had cactus. And here's where they cook it. The bean taco is very good, but nothing special. Yeah, good flavor. I mean, just bean. Not too salty. Fresh. Nothing special. Okay, here's the cactus one.
with this is a queso fresco cheese. The cactus taco is no good at all. Dry and just weird and sour. No good. And we got the potato one. From the looks of it, this actually might be the best one. Those potatoes. Yeah, here's the inside of the potato taco. Fresh guac. Looks very good. All right, we're at the Cosmo. It's the Philly. It's a steak sandwich here at their restaurant.
Bronx Bomber.
Got a bunch of stuff in there. The sandwich with a side of fries. Fries look real good. Big. Oh, yeah. So, take a bite and look inside.
There's a steak sandwich. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, look at that. This is the best thing we had today.
I would skip those tacos. That China Poblano place is no good. This is the good stuff. $16. Fries were $5 for extra fries. Or not. For fries. It doesn't come with it.
Few desserts from Park MGM, Italy. Some cream puff. I don't know. Remember what that is in that. Now look at this cannoli. This is a pistachio cannoli. Pistachio filled cannoli cream. The cannoli is probably the best cannoli I've had. The sweet cream pistachio. You don't really taste pistachio. It's just like sweet cream flavor with bits of pistachio. But the shell is the crispiest cannoli I've ever had. Freshest. Very nice. As far as these were concerned, the cream puff is the star of the show. Amazing flavor of this. It's not like regular whipped cream or anything. This is something special. The rest, you could just forget about. But that's the one to get. We are at Yellowtail in Bellagio, my favorite restaurant in Vegas. All right, here's the angry salmon. From Yellowtail. Looks good. Looks very good. Side of mushrooms. Halibut. The chicken. And the ribeye. Wow. It's like chicken dark meat cut underneath, and then on top they put the breast. It's good, but compared to the other dishes, this would be last choice. But yeah, the halibut was amazing as always, and the steak is wonderful. This is a whole pie from Secret Pizza of Cosmopolitan. This was $36. Great price. Two topping.
34.
After tax, it's 36. Raining and it's beautiful. Moonlight in Vermont. I see finger waves, ski trails on a mountainside.
You can see the snow now. Look at it. Look at that. Snowing in Vegas. On the strip. Look at all that coming across. Wow.
Well, that's going to do it for my Bellagio stay. Still, I mean, we're going to go to Venetian after this, so we're going to compare. But I'm going to say customer service, just when you walk in, your eyes relax, kind of like the Grand Floridian. Everything top-notch. It's the best hotel on the Strip. And food-wise, Yellowtail is the number one. Prime was much better than it was last time, but it's very overpriced, $91 for a, what was it, $89 for the ribeye. Very good, very flavorful. Al Gratin is the star. That was $18, I think, but Yellowtail's number one. That little food tour we did yesterday, that Philly steak sandwich, I think was a highlight. Wouldn't go back to Jose, what was that, China Poblano. It was very disappointing. Nothing special. And yeah, those are the highlights. So, wonderful trip. Bellagio's the best. Let's see how Venetian is. It is snowing here at the Bellagio in Las Vegas on the Strip. Look at the snow. Look at the snow. Zoom in here. It is snowing on the Strip. Look at this. Look at this snow. Hey, let's go by the fountain real quick. Man, it is cold. Welcome everybody to the Venetian Las Vegas. Gonna be here for a couple nights. Just came back, just left the Bellagio. Was there for a couple nights. Let's compare them. All right, here's the hallway. Looks nice. Oh my my. Oh yeah, this is beautiful. Elegant. Wonderful. Lots of room. Look at this. TV here too. Let's see this view. Not bad. It's a pool area. Mirage. Yeah, the room is so cozy. I mean, obviously it's much bigger than the other rooms because it's all suites here. But the other important thing is colors and decor. And yep, I prefer this over the Bellagio. So room-wise, this is the number one room in at least standard rooms, you know, in Vegas. I mean, look at that. The lighting is nice and like yellowish tint. Might not come through on the video, but it's all yellow tinted. Got some robes in here. And bathroom is much better than Bellagio's. It doesn't have, Bellagio didn't have a separate tub, and it didn't have a door for the shower. It's a long shower. And also, I don't think I showed it on video, but the water pressure was no good. So, and they couldn't fix it either. So I asked them if they could change the shower head or something, but got a TV in here too. Let's see the toilet here. Where's the light? Okay, very nice. And they got a separate mirror here to powder your bottom. Let's see the water pressure before I forget. Yeah, it's definitely better than Bellagio's. Looks good.
Looks good.
So yeah, beautiful room, beautiful. Just gotta figure out and see if I could connect stuff to the HDMI, the TV. Yeah. Oh, the mountains are still, it's still raining down. It's raining down there. No more snow. Looks like. Oh. I don't know if it shows in this video, but my other video, same day of today that I checked out of Bellagio, it was snowing in Vegas. It was beautiful. Oh yeah, you know what time it is. Oh yeah. I'm gonna go on my iPad, play some 3DS, maybe some Nintendo Switch, maybe eat a slice of pizza while I'm sitting in here.
In this romantic setting, are so hypnotized by the lovely evening summer breeze, warbling of a meadow.
All right, here's the lighting. Very nice lighting. And the couch does turn into a bed, so that's nice. Very, very nice. Very nice. Look at this. We are at Grand Lux Cafe in the Venetian. It's 1:30 in the morning. And these are the fried wontons. Avocado. Man, they look amazing. Look at these things. Yeah, they're huge. Oh, man, I can't wait to bite into it. Look at this beautiful Caesar salad. Oh, man. Ooh-wee. These are really good. Very good. Let me bite into this so you can see it. Here we go. Also, oh yeah. Real fresh. Real good. Look at this huge, beautiful lemon chicken piccata. Oh my goodness. The mushrooms, capers, whole breasts. Wonderful. This chicken, this dish is perfect. You can chew so easily through it, the chicken. It's just succulent and got this beautiful capers, nice lemony flavor, creamy. This is one of the best dishes. Amazing. Look at that. I could get used to this. I'm playing Zelda Breath of the Wild while the other TV's on and I'm watching Everybody Loves Raymond. You know what? This is kind of spoiling me here. Oh, man. Anyways. At the Venetian. What a day. What a beautiful day. changing it. So wonderful. Wow, volcano show, amazing. Just a tropical getaway. With slot machines.
Watching the Laker game here at the Mirage Sportsbook. Pretty nice.
He's going to be over 30. He's been averaging
pretty big.
36 minutes per game on the season. Schroeder scores. That's seventh in the league. And actually, his minutes have gone up the last month.
We are at Spago and Bellagio. This is a lamb and beef pasta.
This is a salmon.
We are at Spago.
Both dishes are fantastic. This is al dente, kind of. Tastes very fresh, house made, not salty or anything like that. Great flavor. Salmon, great. Melts in your mouth, a little spicy and sweet. Thank you. Frankie. Both dishes were amazing. Fantastic.
All right, today is checkout day from the Venetian. And here's the issue with Venetian. It feels a little cold, like soul-wise. Like it's more, less, so it's like soulless almost, a little. Feels like so, but the room was beautiful. I mean, it's a beautiful place, but if I rank it third, the third hotel in Las Vegas to stay in, number one is Bellagio, number two is Wynn/Encore. This would be number three. Those two are better to stay. So that's how I would, even though the room is like bigger. Yeah, and the casino floor is pretty small, unless you go to Palazzo, but still, it's a kind of a soulless place, a little. It doesn't have warmth to it. Bellagio has so much warmth. Encore, Wynn has warmth, feeling-wise, you know? Not temperature, but beautiful place here. So I'm going back to Bellagio for one more night to end my trip. Gonna be in a Staywell Premier 2 Queen room. Got greenery here in the hallway. Interesting. All right, here we are at the Bellagio, the Staywell 2 Queen room. And if you notice, that hallway had like a greenery wall. That's different than the regular tower. Beautiful. The decor is the same. Here's the differences I noticed. You got this thing here with the time, and I don't know what. Got to figure that one out. And this huge thing here. I think it's an air purifier. Yeah, it says Rabbit Air. Interesting. I requested a pool view like I did in my other room. And the thing is, these are on the high floors, 23rd and 24th floors, and I like to be closer, get a bigger view of the pool, but this is good enough. See the mountains back there. But yeah, I mean, the room, comparing this with the Venetian, obviously the Venetian room is an upgraded looking suite, huge room, but like the extra room we didn't use, the extra, and I do like the colors, but the feeling of being here at the Bellagio and staying here is so much better than the Venetian. You don't get the feeling from video or pictures. You get, if you just look at it, you'll say, oh yeah, the Venetian room, much bigger, nicer. But in reality, when you stay here, Bellagio overall, it's just
fantastic. Now, this is the thing I was wondering about.
This shower head with the vitamin C filtered water that comes out. So I'm gonna turn that on and see how the pressure is and what this is all about. Is it, yeah. But the bathroom itself, very nice. Again, the thing I don't like is the fact that it doesn't have a separate tub and it's the doorless. So the vapor and the water, it doesn't heat up when you're in the shower, you know, like a spa. If there was a door, it would keep all the, you know, I don't even know how to say it, you know, the steam. Can't believe I forgot that word. The steam in. So yeah, but this is beautiful. Now we're gonna find out and see what these all do, these machines and stuff. But let's take a look at the shower for now. Okay, let's see the pressure. Pressure looks the same as the other room, the regular room. But yeah, once I take a shower and go under the water and all that, I'll see if does it smell different? Is it, I don't know, does it feel different? What is this filter all about, you know?
Yeah, Bellagio's number one, I gotta say. Oh, this probably, let's see, oh, okay. I hit home and then this stuff comes on. What is this? It's the lights or something? Oh, it's the brightness of this. Okay. I mean, this. Oh, there's music. No, it's audio. I don't know. I thought you can maybe control the lights or something with this. Home. Oh, here. What's that? Oh. It's got a glow. Whoa. It's very bright. It's flickering through the video, but it's not flickering in person. It's like a sun glow. Yeah, that's cool. I think at night when the room is like darker, and this will give a nice glow, like a flame glow or a red, orange glow. This might be actually a really cool thing. Okay. Now this air purification system. What the heck is this all about here? Oh. It's got a mood light button. Oh, the mood light is just this blue light. It looks like a PlayStation 5. Interesting. Speed. What do we got here? Low, medium, high. Turbo. Let's turbo filter this air. You hear it? I can hear it. It's like a PlayStation 5 playing, I don't know, Horizon. The second one, or or Final Fantasy 7 Remake, the PlayStation 4. Anyways, gaming talk. Yeah, I'll tell you what, just right now, first glance, I wouldn't pay extra for this, you know, not really, but maybe bodily, from the filtered air to the filtered water for the shower, maybe it makes a difference. See a jacuzzi? Jacuzzi. Yeah, very nice. Very happy to be back at Bellagio. By the way, Mirage is on the top list as well. Just the feeling of being there. Unfortunately, they're gonna change it, but as of right now, still the same. That would be hotel number 4 on the list. Yes, even below Caesars. I don't like Caesars that much, staying there. Very disappointing, especially customer service. Anyways, welcome to the Bellagio. Beautiful. Going to Sardell's for lunch. Gonna get that tuna sandwich I've always wanted to try there. Beautiful. Wonderful.
Okay, here's the tuna sandwich, tuna melts. I added tomato and lettuce at Saudel's. Looks pretty good. Comes with a pickle spear, fries. Here's the onion rings at Saudel's. It's pretty good. Pretty good. We had them come and change the shower head, and look at the pressure now. Beautiful. Very nice. The world famous halibut. The best dish. One of the best dishes in all of Vegas.
Some soy sauce. Man.
This is the filet mignon, and it's sizzling. Look at this.
Oh, wow.
With a yuzu or something, is that? Look at that. Mm. Wow. This is the short rib.
No.
That's the steak, that's medium. Nice.
Oh, look at that short rib.
Wow. Here is inside the short rib. Very moist. Very melt in your mouth. Yeah, take it. I cut it for you. This is just melting your mouth. The short rib, sweetness to it. I dip it in wasabi a little bit there. And the steak, the filet was fantastic too.
Look at that.
The mushrooms. Very good. The sizzling plate. Yellowtail is one of those places that everything tastes really good.
Yeah. Look at this beautiful pizza from Secret Pizza. Cosmopolitan. Oh yeah.
All right. As I sit here about to play Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, greatest video game ever made, in my Bellagio two queen Staywell room. I'm gonna wrap up my stay here in Vegas, Venetian versus Bellagio. All the food places I ate at. By the way, I put towels over some of these lights and pillowcase stuff because I like lighting in a certain nice glow. Not too bright, not too dark. You know, when I put it, it's beautiful. Anyways. Bellagio hands down beats Venetian 100%. Room isn't as big, but this is cozy. It's beautiful. Bellagio itself has a soul, has heart, has a feeling when you stay here that you don't get through the video. Venetian feels a little hollow, a little industrial, like a little, what do you call it? Corporate. Customer service here, I had some issues here and there, and they took care of me without question. Venetian, there was a few issues. They weren't as open to going above and beyond. Bellagio does it in spades. Prime Steakhouse at Bellagio, first time I went, was no good on my last trip. But this time I went and got the, what was it? The ribeye, $89. One of the best steaks I've had. However, not worth $89. Even though it was one of the best steaks I had, it's just way too much money for a steak. Even though I'm in Vegas, etc., etc. The au gratin potatoes, though, unbelievable. $18 for that side, but nowhere has au gratin potatoes other than Prime Steakhouse, so that was really nice. Yellowtail, bar none, the best restaurant in Vegas that I've been to ever. And I've been to quite a few. Everything at Yellowtail is fantastic. The halibut is number one. The short was fall off the bone, succulents. The ribeye was so-so. The first time I had it was amazing. The second time I had it was so-so. The filet was really good on that sizzling plate. Grand Lux Cafe in Venetian, that is a go-to. That chicken, what did I get? A chicken piccata. Unbelievable. So much food, great price, and they're open 24 hours. That was really nice there. Where did we go to? I think the last time we went to
Lago. No, not Lago, Spago. The pasta was great. The salmon was so tender. So good. But my number one restaurant would be Yellowtail. So that was fantastic. And again, Bellagio, number one. I wouldn't pay extra for a Staywell room. Unless you get a comp free upgrade or something is nice. The shower that I used that was filtered water and stuff was nice, but I don't really feel a difference, you know? So I'm sure on a micro level, it's different. Air purification system that we have down there. Yeah, I'm sure it's good, you know? But the regular room, I'm sure the filter for the regular air conditioning that it has is fine too. I don't smell any differences or anything like that. But yeah, Bellagio is the place to stay. You'll get a feeling here that you won't get at any other hotel in Las Vegas. Classy, so classy, sophisticated. It's elegant. And again, it might not come across as the most amazing in pictures and video, although the fountain's unbelievable and everything, but fantastic, fantastic place. So thank you for joining me on this journey. Can't wait to continue. Again, I usually do Disney and Universal, and mostly Disney hotels and stuff, and Disneyland and all that. So I'm excited to go back to that, of course, very soon. But anywho, have a wonderful day, evening, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.